I actually did not hear about this until recently. I've long since known that it was going to be revived, but I had no idea that some news had been dropped about it, seeing that this was one of my more favorite animated series in a very, very long time. I'm here to tell you, and since I reviewed most of season 2, but not all of it, yes, I am talking about Young Justice. As you may know, a miracle happened after Samurai Jack suddenly came back. A couple of months or weeks later, it was revealed that Young Justice would also come back. In a way, we prayed to the heavens and said, "At long last, fans cries here." But then they had to be a little bit bullying by saying it is not going to be on Netflix. A lot of people wanted this show to come back, me included. I mean, it was one of the best animated shows I have ever seen. Why did I think like that? Well, the animation, the action, the maturity, the getting the crap past the radar jokes, the characters, oh, and let's not forget the voice cast. Oh my god, the voice cast! It was one of the best and most diverse voice cast I have ever seen, which was one of the reasons why I always liked Young Justice. However, given what has happened to a lot of the different voice casts, it's not exactly confirmed yet if everyone will come back. Either way, now I'm talking about this news I recently read. Apparently, this new third season, which will be premiered in 2018. Well, once again, a long wait, but hey, we're humankind, right? All we do is wait. Either way, this third season is called Young Justice Outsiders, and according to the source, it's gonna air alongside a live-action Titan series, which, by the way, what? Are you serious? Either way, according to the information, this third season will be even darker than anything before, and that's saying something. I mean, it's been Young Justice to Second Seasons has been a little bit like this, you know. It's no, I mean, don't. It is dark, but at the same time, not too dark. Or more like they approach some things in a light-hearted way, even though it is dark. Especially that moment where, you know, Calder was Aqualad was an undercover person, or the fact that they did a covert option when the Cobra Venom. So yeah, it is pretty dark. But now they're saying it's gonna get even darker. And this third season will apparently be a little bit, what is that word? Well, no, that was not the word I was looking for. I mean, I was gonna say something like, not controversial, but apparently the reason why this is called Outsiders is because the team will be tackling a meta-human trafficking and a lot of different villains, something like where society will be caught in with genetic arm race and from both the globe and the galaxy and anything more, maybe even manufactured superhumans. The second season was the fact that the metagene was invented, well, not invented, were brought inside people. Are we gonna tell, are we gonna see that again, or are we gonna see something more? The second season ended with Vandal Savage, badass by the way, shaking hands, or at least greeting hands, with freaking Darkseid, evil incarnate, shook hands with a human, though, nonetheless. It's not exactly confirmed that Darkseid is going to be in the third season, but given these hints about the meta-human trafficking and the fact that we're gonna face enemies from globe and galaxy, it could be very well that Apocalypse will play a role in this one too. As I said before, the second season was about this metagene, weaponizing it as the Reach try to do. I'm pretty sure that's gonna be taken up again, this time by the Light. The Light has been split up, but they will undoubtedly come back. How will it happen? Now let's talk about this so-called darker theme. Darker missions as a coming-of-age story where kids becomes adults. Are we now gonna see some more deaths? Or are we gonna see some more shocks? Who knows? Then, now let's talk about I mean, I'm sorry, that was just some short things, but I'm not a theorist. I cannot guess what will happen. But I can only say if it's gonna be a human trafficking, maybe it's gonna be like an underground fighting ring against humans, similar to that ring in Justice League a long time ago, or maybe even darker. Maybe it's going to be preying more on children who hates the world and turning them into that. Maybe Darkseid or the others will try to do it anything else. I mean, I still find it very hard to believe that Darkseid is going to be in an alliance with Vandal Savage. Granted, this Darkseid may not be as dangerous as previous Darkseid, but it is freaking Darkseid. I find it very hard to believe he's teaming up with a human. Then again, there's not exactly confirmed on why Clarion the Witch Kid decides to follow Vandal Savage's role. I mean, way every single time too. I mean, he joined the light only because it's fun, but he's a freaking lord of chaos. Power unimaginable. How come he follows someone who's a 50,000-year-old human? I think it's because he just simply thinks that Vandal is cool. I mean, 50,000 years of life, he has practically seen everything and as a human. I think that's the reason why Darkseid and Clarion respects Vandal. He's just that enlightened. But human trafficking is gonna be like war and many things else. Maybe even some glimpse of racism. After all, we cannot forget that the Gordon, that guy who is allied with Darkseid, is trying to break down the trust with in the heroes. Won't be surprising if that's gonna be put up on this one too. And will there be death? Will Superboy die as been suspected? Or will there be someone else? Will Kid Flash return? You can give me those thoughts. But before we end this video, let's talk about the one thing that is bad news bears about this new season. And that's the fact that it's going to air on a new streaming service built by the WW called the Warner Brothers Digital Network. And why is that bad news? Because that means you have to subscribe, make an account, I think, if you want to see every single service of the WWA, I mean the Warner Brothers. Not that I actually understand how business works, nor do I affect how Netflix suddenly became so freaking ass popular, but really, people, you still going with greed? I mean, the only reason I heard it was Young Justice cancelled because it was popular with chicks for some reason. I'm saying for some reason because I haven't seen a single female reviewer of Young Justice yet. But hey, if they're so popular with young females, how come I didn't find a date? Okay, jokes aside, let's be serious here. How about Netflix? Netflix have gotten so popular, so why couldn't it just air like that? Could it be, though, that they didn't want to air every single episode? I mean, after all, most animated shows there has been animated into a whole season. So I fear, once again, this third season will be the only season we'll get. Simply because people, maybe even me included, will not watch that streaming service. Because, well, it's complicated. We do not like complicated things. People and a lot of other people of the world, we are greedy, selfish people by nature. Every single one of us. So of course we don't want to take that service. We will always prefer the cheap and easy way. That is why I feel like Netflix would have been a good thing. At least people feel like that's not too cheap and that's easy. Alas, it's going to be air on this streaming service. We should be happy. We got a third season. But I want at least two seasons more. A third and a fourth. I won't be satisfied. I mean, I want a fifth. But if we could at least get those two, that would quell my worry only a little bit. That's most what I have to tell about this news. I know it wasn't really anything good, but 2018, Young Justice will premiere. Not exactly stated on when, but it's gonna be a long time. But we're used to the wait. Give me your thoughts if you have any.